particularly because this is a very special day. We're delighted to have such a big audience, boys and girls, and kids, colleagues. This is not a regular assembly, sure it's not, because it's not even a Friday, and we're having a big special assembly, and we only in St. Ultans have special assemblies when there's something very important to do. And every school in the country today is sitting in their holla having a very special assembly to read out the proclamation that their school has written for the next 100 years. So mammies, daddies, grannies, granddads, it's so good to be here to join with us on this momentous occasion because it only happens, it will only happen every 100 years. And please God, in 100 years time, St. Ultans will still be standing. Some of us here won't be still standing. The memory again, like the people from 1960, the memory will live on. Over the past, since September, the boys and girls, I'm sure they've been telling you as part of the rubber wall yet, have been working very hard on the preparations for today. And they've worked hard with three very important people here. On my right, Erlesh, we have Mutor Aiden. Erlay, on my left, we have Mutor Emer. And Mutor Gary, who unfortunately can't be with us today, has put an hour of work into the children's education around 1960 and how everything happened. In junior infants, the boys and girls studied and researched the Irish flag. All the lovely colours, where it came from, they made flags, they coloured flags, did all of that in the infant classes. Then in Rongaheen, Rongado, they were looking at the life. What was life back then in 1916 for a group of our colleagues? Would they have had a school uniform? Would they have even been going to school? Were there schools back then in Ireland? And what kind of food did boys and girls eat for their lunch and for their dinners and for their breakfast? So all of that was very, very interesting. The life and times of people back in 1916, the social study really for children is fascinating. And sports as well. Well, we all know that there was plenty of GAA and all of that. So but times have changed as well. So the boys and girls have looked at what was life like back then. And now, in 2016, what's the same? Is there anything that's still the same and what's different? One of the most, like in third, fourth, fifth and sixth, there's a lot of study like that during history time, social science time. But I think you'll agree with me that one of the most impressive products of the past 5 months study have been these wonderful pieces of art from the various class. Was it Ronald Cooling and Ronald Shane? It was Ronald Cooling and Ronald Shane. And Ronald Reed project where I was in So as the morning, I'm only introducing and I'm going to hand over now to the experts at St. Ultans, and they're going to take you through a wonderful assembly. We're recording this, so we'll have it on the website for posterity and for times to come. Also, I suppose it's significant that we had an election recently ourselves, because senior classes studied the politics of 1916, the government, how Ireland was run back then. And I think it's wonderful for children to have that sense of where they come from, where we all come from, and how far we've come as well. And the brave people of 1916 that really, they wanted to make Ireland a better place, the bottom line, that was their bottom line, to make things better for everybody. So really, our proclamation today is going to explain to everybody what matters most to the Bukhari and Khalidi and families here in St. Ultans. So I now hand you over to Mr. Ames and Mr. Beamer.
Thank you, Mr. Beamer. You're all very welcome here today. As we said, it's a huge occasion, as Mr. Beamer mentioned. None of us will probably be here in 100 years, but St. Ultans is still here. And maybe even to think that our new population for our generation, that these six class in Khalidi are going to read out. This time 100 years, they'll be looking at that, so we're making our own little bit of history here today. Richard, you mentioned the flag being raised outside as well.
Did anyone notice the different flag in this morning? flag up with our chest.
Ireland.
The Irish flag. So every single morning today, just raise the flag and then take it down later. That's a very important thing.
Yeah.
Ed, would you like to tell us something about the Rising?
Yes,
they had tanks. And what else? They're gone very quiet today. Junior, it's at the end.
Emmy.
Where's Adam? Oh, I don't know. Victor was great as well. And seeing
Emmy went in to visit the GPO and everything.
What? Emmy went into town on the bus to visit the GPO.
Yes.
Emmy, what would you like to tell us?
Children of Saint Ultans.
So we're going to be really quiet and they're going to deliver it in their best speech voice and dream it, just like four appears outside the GPO 100 years ago. And then when they finish, we're all going to stand, and I know all the boys and girls have been practicing their national anthem, and we're going to think about the past 100 years and look forward to the next 100, and we all sing the national anthem together. So can I welcome Josh, Veronica, Jesus, Daniel, Ellie, and Zoe.
We'll make it happen.